Good afternoon, my dear friends. Happy Passover to our Jewish friends all over the world. I am here today to talk about a couple of interesting things, actually. I hope you can hear me well, despite that I'm outside and there is water sound and other noises. So in case you come on and you can't hear me, let me know. On Wednesday last week, I had my first eye, the right eye cataract surgery. So it's interesting. I love to put makeup on my eyes. So I feel at times self-conscious not having makeup on. But the interesting thing is the fact that the minute that they opened my right eye, it was as if somebody put fluorescent light bulbs in my eyes. So if I cover my right eye, I see everything with a yellowish, grayish background. And if I wanna see with my right eye, even though I have sunglasses now because the light is too much, I see everything bright with white background. So it was interesting. I wanted to share. I don't know if any of you have had that surgery. If you want to come on or send me a message how you were feeling, I would appreciate it. The other thing is I'm talking about permission to be you in our classes tonight, in our workshop. And I just want to bring up a couple of things that I'm going to be speaking about tonight. So if you guys like to think about these subjects in your life, I would really appreciate it if you share it with me. A lot of times we don't believe in ourselves. We don't, when we were a little kid, we were compared with others. Or as we grew older, we started comparing ourselves with others. So it doesn't give us that permission to be our own self. On our own powerful self that we could be. The other one is listening to others. And by doing that, even though a lot of people have our best interests in mind, it's not what we really have in mind in our life. So that's another one. Then not believing in yourself, thinking that it's never the right time to do something. And I love the Nike logo that says, just do it. A lot of times I say, if you really want to do it, just do it. Just jump in and try doing what you need to do, because you won't know unless you do it. And after all, if you make a mistake, it's the best thing that could have happened to you, because if you make a mistake, it means that you did something and you're not going to do it again and you're going to do something else. So you become successful. Like Colonel Sanders, founder of Kentucky Fried Chicken, he always said that he failed so many times that without those failures, he could not figure out what worked. And that's what worked. Eventually, after knocking on everybody's door for so many times and being rejected, they found out that his recipe is one of the best recipes in the world. So he became such a famous Kentucky Fried Chicken guy. The other one is getting to know yourself and trusting in yourself and your instincts. And taking risks, so making those risks become realities. And this is all about putting your step forward and do what you want to do. I often ask my clients and my students to write a list. Writing a list on your phone, on your paper, on a journal is a fantastic idea. Bring out all the positive things that you have done in your life till now. And if you're a negative person, that, a lot of us might be, why don't you start writing all the negative stuff first that you have issues with, your challenges, and then turn them around to positive? If you have any questions, if you have any issues with doing that, if that's a huge challenge for you, I would be more than glad to help you to change the negatives into positives for you so you can see the difference. So you can comment below whenever you watch this video and let me know, or contact me, privately message me, and we go from there. And what can you do to accept yourself? A lot of times I say the best thing to do to accept yourself can start with meditation. I mean, as simple as it is, self-acceptance and even saying affirmations to yourself that you don't believe. Like, if you don't love yourself and you don't accept yourself, just say, I love and accept myself. Say it so many times as an affirmation that I jokingly say, fake it until you make it. Your subconscious will pick up on it. And one day you come and look in the mirror and you look at yourself and say, oh my God, I love what I see. And that's the product of what you can do with your subconscious mind. Keep going and going and telling your subconscious mind that you love and accept yourself for who you are. The product of loving and accepting for yourself for who you are gives you permission to love and accept others the way they are. And if you are unhappy in your life, a lot of times it comes to the point that you keep finding issues and challenges and you want to be sad and a victim and upset and all this stuff, and you want company. So misery loves misery. And the same way that that's true, happiness loves happiness. And if you're happy, if you're, you know, joyful, people want to be around you. People want to have you in their life. People want to have your energy. So why not to be happy? Not, you know, why not accept yourself for who you are? You are wonderful. You're fantastic. You're present. You know, you're a gift. So with all that said, I don't know what my sound looks like or sounds like, so I'm going to say goodbye to you all. If you have any questions, if you still want to join me in my Making a Commitment for Love workshop tonight, you can still join. We are on the pillar of permission to be you. That's the sixth pillar. We have another one, another five to go. So I think that we are going to be on for quite a while. And we are becoming a family, so it will be nice if you want to join our family and be a part of us. As always, keep safe and healthy, and know that I love you wherever you are. Till next time, I see you. Bye-bye.